great examples of self-advocacy. So some members of the audience are wondering, how did you learn how to advocate for yourself? Kirsten, if you want to start, that would be great.
I learned when I was very young, actually. I was probably about 14 or 15 in 2008 when my mom told me about Trump's Thunder came out. And I was, of course, very nervous on the BBC channel. And I just stand up for running out and how the R word is very insulting to everyone who is disabled. Never say the word. It's never okay. And because of it, in that same year, maybe a few months after or something, I got an award for that big achievement of my life. And I was so happy. And it's always good to stand up for what you believe in. Because before all of this, I was very shocked. But not anymore. Since for my wings, I am a new person and independent. I'm so glad to be here.
We're very proud to have you here. Being able to advocate for yourself and advocating for causes that you believe in. I throw it to the rest of the panel. It's going to be a tough act to follow, though.
As far as advocating for myself, it was definitely a process in the beginning. Well, part of my story, a little bit, is I suffered from a TBI at age 4, and so really my journey started from a very young age, and being 27 now, that's over 23 years of this journey. So I was blessed that I had my mother advocating for me at that time. So she was really wanting to step up to the plate with the school system, with doctors, everything I needed. So at one point, yes, it's expected that the young adult may not be ready to advocate for themselves, but it's a process. It's kind of like exercise. You can't go from being sedentary to running 5K. You have to just, you know, walk 5 minutes a day, increase it steadily. It's the same thing with advocating, I think. If you push someone off that cliff too soon, you need to really just, and I think advocate for me, I never thought of myself as that, I just share experiences. So I think the word advocate may not even be, you know, the term you use right now. I just think to share, you know, your perspective. And I think it's definitely a process, but as long as you really tailor it to what they're comfortable with, as well as inspiring them, it'll be fine.
For me, it was really my parents. They really helped me become my own advocate. As they were saying, you know, it is a process. You know, you do learn as you go along. And, you know, my parents were always there advocating for me. But as I grew up, you know, they made me more to be more vocal, and they got me to be, you know, more involved in my community, which helped me be able to talk and explain more about myself and, you know, advocate and learn and become a leader in the community. And because of that, I was able to start to proceed and learn a little bit more about myself. And I think that was the most important thing, especially in college for me, is, as I said before, it was really learning about myself. I was always one in high school to kind of throw my disability aside. But you know, as I said before, going into college, you had to do all the things for yourself, and it was a new environment, a new community. So you had to be able to go and explain about yourself, and you know, I attribute all that